Welcome back to Let's Play Baldur's Gate 2, Shadows of Om, Enhanced Edition.
I can dance on the head of a pin as well.
Stuff, I'm Amethyst Lunatari.
Fine.
Okay, move over there.
What?
Well, kind of not in a good spot. Wait a second. So we came from there, alright. Let's just run
Where
over
Minsk
here.
Minsk goes, evil stands aside.
We need to gather together.
Faster than Chick, take a fast pause.
Nature, it is done.
No fast pause. Alright, so what we want to do... I want to summon some elementals here. There are some tough guys back there. Oh, you don't have it, but I do. I thought they were fighting each other. It always reminds me of Ignis from... Wait a second.
I am willing.
Okay, so we have to concentrate on our elemental, but Jahir is automatically, immediately ready.
Jump on my sword while you can, evil. I won't be as gentle.
I want to try to get everyone included in this.
I go.
Oh, the Earth Elemental turned against.
Fallen!
Who is he? He attacks. I don't remember which one had the Earth.
Live by the sword. Live a good long time.
So he's going after whoever attacked, whoever conjured him, I'm sure.
What do you need?
I am skilled in avoidance.
Yeah, I didn't intend for this to happen. Oh, there you go. We're fine.
Stand back for justice!
Just stay where you are. Trying to get closer to you.
Battle, Bo. Run, Bo, run!
As I would have done. Trust is very foolish.
Stay with us.
Yeah, I'll do it.
You guys not like each other. They're trying to get away from each other. Alright, let's do this. It's last for quite a while. Not silence. Where is it? I'm just looking for it. Okay, here we go. Alright, protection from evil. And haste. And Aerie will cast invisibility on me after that stuff happens. Okay. Improved invisibility. All right.
Such menial tasks.
Make way, villainy. Hero coming through. Butt kicking for goodness.
All right. Wait a second. Wait a second. No. Wait. Cloud kill. There we go. That's what I like to see. Away with you. Alright, I'm starting to get hit.
A simple matter.
So I wonder if the elementals will be unaffected by the cloud kill.
Fine. Yes, such menial tasks.
Air elemental. See if they can get through. Okay, cool. Oh. I think Zoral is one of the spellcasters. Well. So tempting because he's almost dead. You attack him, you attack him. I'll wipe your filthy lineage right out of the realms, Rengar says. Well, that's all well and good, but where are you? Oh, you know what? Okay. Attacking at range. Dart of stunning. So I'm gonna use these. I don't want him running into the cloud kill. Unless he might be able to stun people. That'd be great. Actually, if you're gonna do that, do it to the mage. And what can we do here? Silence, yeah. Not good. Yeah, we're busy destroying you, or some of you. I'm not paying for simply walking by. Yes. Fall before us, all that stuff. Okay, Zoral's dead. We've got Tarnor and Drogfi, and then here. I forgot about these protective spells here. Blur and mirror image. Looks like he's just running over, so I'll have him switch to melee.
That's not right!
Did you cast silence? I'm going by very quickly. I think I belayed that order on her. I didn't mean to do that. Which means the silence is gone. Yeah, that's my mistake. Bolt of Glory. Oh, wait. 6d6. Alright. Maybe switch back to melee. I'll be walking right into the fog there. Oh, he disappeared. The mage disappeared. Alright.
Yes?
Well, in that case... mages do next. Throw an acid arrow with this guy.
Great fun!
Right. Oh, wow.
What is it?
All right. The mage is the last one left.
Your life in this faulty. A simple magic.
It has no effect.
Hit to no effect. So he's got that. Resistance to magical weapons or something? Spell thrust. Let's dispel... I don't know if it dispels that, but maybe it'll dispel something. Got him. I think. Yeah, he's dead. Nice. Full plate mail. I like to sell those. This will wake someone from a sleep spell. Or power word sleep. Alright, well, let's get out of the cone of...
Where Minsk goes, evil stands aside.
Not the cone of cold, but let's get out of the cloud kill. Oh, he's... Well, he's near death. And he's unable to move. I guess he was held by one of these mages. All Alright, cool.
Jump on my sword while you can, evil. I won't be as gentle.
We did it. No one died. We're actually in pretty good shape. Skydrop gem. Oh wow. Some money, honey. Another skydrop gem. Money. Zios gem. I got the wrong person picking up all this stuff. You can have that. Amy, you can have this as well. Paralyzation wand. Maybe a quick get out of trouble if it works. Okay. A scroll of summon Nishru. More plate mail. A lot of magical stuff. One bolt throwing axe. Small shield. Full plate mail. Let's start picking it up. A morning star. That's an interesting looking morning star. Okay, well, Aerie can learn this summon Nishu. That's a bolt of biting for our friend here. Or six bolts of biting. Throwing axe. Small shield plus two. I have to have Aerie identify this. Full plate mail, so I have to identify that as well. Well, actually she can only identify one thing. Let's just save, and I'm gonna have her learn this scroll here. Summon Nishru, and then identify spell. Full plate mail plus one. Armor class is zero. She can wear full plate mail? I didn't know Jahira could. Okay. Armor class -5. Up from -3. Awesome. And this chainmail plus +3. Faconia can wear that. Oh, I'm not sure if she can wear it. She needs strength. 8 strength. Alright, she has 10 strength. Alright, let's see. -2. Now -3 armor class. Yay! Mail of the dead. Alright, I'm gonna put this in the bag of holding. And then this, I'll identify with a scroll, but we'll wait until we pick up the rest of the magic items. I have 5 slots. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And now that one. Okay. Helm of Charm Protection. As its name suggests, the Helm of Charm Protection protects its wearer from any magical attempts at emotional manipulation. As a precaution, some high-profile mercenary groups regularly equip their members with such helmets to ensure they can perform their prescribed duties without external interference. So, of course, immune to charm and critical hits. So, let's see. I think one of us already has one. Minsk has the helm of Baldur'an. Which has all this stuff. It's pretty sweet. Especially the Thaco and the armor class. And the saving throws. Hit points are negligible. But, he would be great with the charm helmet. But that would mean he goes down in all this stuff, so... She has the helm of charm protection. I don't think he can wear a helm. Oh! Yeah, he also has a helm of charm protection. Well, this is a regular helmet, so... Yeah, give me this. And you can wear this one. Awesome. Alright, so... Plate mail plus one. Did I just randomly identify that? That was the thing I couldn't identify. Okay. Oh no, I had... No, it was the other thing. That airy... Identified. So I give this to her. Yeah. It's not as good armor class. Small shield plus two. That's right, she can use a shield. Buckler plus one. Nice. Ares armor class is now negative four. She needs all the help she can get with that stuff. Small shield plus two. That's the one I just gave her, never mind. This is just a regular small shield. Buckler plus one puts her at negative four. I have Minsk dual wielding, so he is not picking that up. And that's a small shield plus one, and that's a plain small shield, so. Throwing axe unidentified. A wyvern's tail plus two. The large spike at the end. At the head of this morning star is actually the lethal stinger of a wyvern. The fighter mage Sidej created this weapon using his magical abilities to keep the stinger capable of producing poison. The magic he used has already made the wyvern's tail a living weapon that pulses with life in the hands of its wielder. I was gonna say it looked like a scorpion tail or something. Hit target must save versus poison or take 5 points of poison damage. That go plus 2, and it's a 2d4 plus 2 damage. It looks like clerics can use it. She would be getting rid of the kneecapper plus one. Which is good against giant humanoids. Well, maybe I'll remember. Inadequate strength, that's why. She's 11 strength to wield this. I'm gonna hold on to it then. If we can ever get her strength up, then she can wear it. Use it. Wield it. Alright, so I need... one identify scroll. Of many. That's why I don't mind using them. Hangard's Axe plus 2. If this weapon had a lofty beginning, it has been overshadowed by the exploits of its most famous owner, Hangard the Dwarf. Hangard made a habit of trying to knock melons and apples off the heads of comrades. He missed more often than not, due in part to an unfortunate fondness for ale. Returns to the wielder's hand when thrown. Thaco plus 2, and damage is 1d6 plus 2. Requires 4 strength. Well, it's an axe. Yeah, I'm going to put it in the bag of holding. I could use a little topping off, couldn't we? Lots of healing to spread around. Alright, can we heal this? I wonder. We can! Look at that! Pretty cool. Back to regular injured. Wow, he needs a lot of healing. Cure critical. This will be our last one for him or it. He's regular injured. What can I do? Other than use all our healing spells, which I don't want to do.
I am ready.
That cure serious. Oh, it's barely injured now. Alright, Yoshimo.
All the world. Fleet of foot and all that.
Any traps around?
The world is blind to my passing.
So that leads back through the middle.
All the world is blind to my passing. All the world is blind to my passing.
All the world. Oops. Kobolds. Oh wow, I killed it right off. Sweet.
All the world is blind to my past. Yoshimo is willing.
Shimo's kicking butt. I mean, they are just regular kobolds. Oh boy! Yeah! Maybe exit stage left here.
All the world is blind to my passing.
I do want to check out the secret door, but I have a feeling the most toughest thing would be in there. Well, let's see. Let's see if we can rest.
All the world is blind to my passing.
Do these disappear if you rest? Let's see. They do. Alright. Alright, so we have all our spells back, and that's freaking awesome, though. Anyway, we're gonna try to deal with these things next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time, and always seek adventure.